Okay, so we went over briefly some things that are important in the profile, and I'm keeping these pieces short so that there won't be any problem with people being able to view them. I want to show you a few things that I have learned that I know is going to be helpful when I go. You know, I'll open this up. I get requests for friendships on a regular basis. It's actually often not the case now that I get. In fact, here is somebody that is a guru that's asking me to be friends, which is kind of cool. But that's not the issue here. What I want to bring out to you is that I get asked to be friends with other people that are network marketers, that are serious people, that are involved with business on a regular basis, because I have built a certain amount of image and influence that I'm going to try to teach you to do for yourself. So one of the things I'm going to do here is explore a couple of profiles, not because it's critical, but because I want to show you some do's and don'ts, because this helps a lot. For instance, we've got this fellow. I assume it's a man because he's got a male name. He has used a pile of money as his profile picture. Okay, there's nothing to give you any idea who he is here. There's only that one picture. He's an Empower Network because he's got an Empower Network blog, so I know he's a network marketer. He might be new, who knows. He has 75 mutual friends, those of which I actually have some connections with, so that part of it's good. But let's think about this from the point of view of somebody that is not doesn't know much about you. They come to your profile, they see this picture. They don't see much in here about who they are. In fact, there's very little, if anything. There's nothing. So either he's got all of his contact information blocked, so that, remember I talked about how important it is for them to see you, or he hasn't put anything here. I don't know which. So what is the very first thing you think about doing? You think about saying, no way, sorry, I'm not interested in you. So that is a really good lesson in what you don't want to do when it comes to that. Okay, then here we go. I just had a counseling session with one of my people, okay? And I'm not going to go in here. I don't want to learn about this. Oh, she's actually sharing my contact. Isn't that cool? See, I put out the Facebook training, and now people are sharing it for me, which is another thing that's kind of new, cool, that you want to have happen. So how does that happen? So let's get real here. When you have friends and Facebook, to be perfectly honest, they only think about themselves. It's about them, them, them. So when you put a lot of cool stuff on your Facebook profile, which of course you want to do, and you want to put good stuff out there so that they're attracted to you, but that is where most people kind of stop. What you're kind of looking for is you're looking for this kind of thing to happen. You're looking for interaction. You're looking for them to share with you your stuff. You're looking for comments. You're looking for likes. But how does that happen when you're brand new? It doesn't happen real fast when you're brand new. So what you have to be willing to do is to put yourself out there and to go find people to talk to first. So what I like to do, and I spend a lot more time there than I do in my own personal profile, is I go out and I look at people that, oh, I know what that's about. I look at people that are putting out interesting comments and threads Like, for instance, I don't do this a lot, but I actually know what this story was. I don't know whether or not you know this story, but I know what this story was about, and it was one of those kind of unfortunate Olympic events. But that's not what this is about. Okay, so what gets your attention? What kinds of threads and pictures and different things that you see out there that you want to be part of and you like people? It depends on who you're connected with, of course. You might see other things here you don't want to look at. And I don't comment about people's personal products and services. I generally don't. So what I do is I look for things that people are saying I find inspiring. Funny. I look for things that are kind of off the wall, not, you know, everybody's doing the same thing. If I don't drink, so I would not comment on something about somebody's drinking. That's okay, that's their choice, but I don't comment about it because I don't do it. And I also, here's something I want to point out. Now, this lady, she's a cool lady, but she often shares and a whole bunch of stuff. So her whole profile is about sharing someone else's stuff. Now, you want to do a little bit of that, but you don't want it to be full of sharing other people's stuff. You want to have your own personality there, too. So what you want to do is you want to look at